Our topic of discussion today will be antral puncture or proof puncture. What are the indications of antral puncture? Diagnostic indications: the antral contents are checked for either cytological, that is for early malignancy, and identification of microorganisms, that is by staining, culture and sensitivity of the contents. What are the therapeutic indications? To drain out the pus in chronic maxillary sinusitis. Contraindications of antral puncture. Acute maxillary sinusitis. In acute cases, that is, ongoing infection is there. So if you go for any procedure, then it might lead to the osteomyelitis of the maxilla. In a case of fracture maxilla, and in children less than 3 years where the development of the bones is not yet complete. Now the procedure is very important. A pack of 4% lignocaine adrenaline is placed in the inferior meatus for around 10 minutes to anesthetize that area. Liquids, trocar and cannula is used, which perforates the lateral wall of the inferior meatus. A point around 1.5 to 2 cm posterior to anterior end of the inferior turbinate is selected, as the bone is very thin here and can be pierced easily. The direction of the trocar is towards the ipsilateral ear. After piercing the wall, the trocar is gently removed. The cannula is then gradually advanced up to a certain extent and then retracted a bit. The antrum is then irrigated at 37 degree and 20 ml normal saline. It will be saline. Complications. So the common complications are the swelling of the cheek, because if it has perforated through the through a different area, then the liquid would get accumulated along the cheek, leading to the swelling of the cheek. Orbital injury, if it perforates through the, you can see in this figure, if it perforates through this wall, that is the floor of the orbit, then it can cause orbital injury. This is the orbit and this is the floor of the orbit or the roof of the maxillary sinus. So if it perforates this, then it can go to the orbit, leading to orbital injury and cellulitis. Bleeding is very common. Ear embolism is one of the rare and dreaded complications of this procedure, and hence we need to avoid air inflation, that is pushing the air through the syringe after we have irrigated the antrum. So in this figure you can see, this is, it has gone, the instrument has pierced through the wall, lateral wall of the nose or the medial wall of the maxillary sinus along the inferior meatus. Then we irrigate, after that we take out the cannula and then irrigate it with the 20 ml normal saline at room temperature, that 37 degree centigrade, and then it comes out through the normal ostium. So this is the procedure. Thank you.